In this follow-up video to running a parametric sweep, we will show you how to post-process your results from a parametric sweep. So you can see we've run a parametric study on the bus bar model, obtaining results for different values of the length and the width of the bus bar. Let's now tabulate the results of our parametric sweep. We can go under the Results tab, and under More Derived Values, we have several options to choose from. Let's select Volume Maximum. So we'll be looking over the entire model geometry and looking for the highest quantity value. First, let's change our data set to reflect the parametric study. And you'll see that provides us with a few more options. I'm going to select All to include all of the values for each parameter in the sweep. But as you can see, you can choose to only show the first or last value or from a list of values. For the geometry, we will select the bus bar only. We will add the bolts later. And for the expression, we're going to want to look at temperature. So let's replace the expression to show that. We can go under Heat Transfer in Solids, Temperature, and select Temperature, and then click Evaluate. Now you can see in the Messages Progress Log window, we have a table of our results. And you can see it contains the 16 combinations of values from our sweep, with the maximum values of the temperature the bus bar exhibits for each set of parameter values. We can view this data graphically in a table surface plot. You can see the length is the horizontal axis for the plot, and the width is the vertical axis, with a color legend displaying the different values for the temperature. So maybe within the plot, we are only interested in a specific range of temperature values, and we want to know the parameter combinations that fall into that range. Well, we can go under the Range section, select Manual Data Range, and adjust the minimum and maximum so we only see the data range that we want. We can also create tables evaluating multiple quantities. Let's change our geometry to the bolts within the bus bar. And again, look at the maximum temperature, so we can just click Evaluate. So now we have the maximum temperature of the bus bar and bolts all within a single table. We can actually edit this table so it has a more suitable description and better labeling of the table columns. To do this, we go under the Tables node and select our table, Table 1, change the label to Maximum Temperature, and then under the Column Header section, we can specify which temperature column belongs to the bus bar, and then the bolts. After you are finished editing your table, you can export it into a variety of different file formats. You can also then copy the data to your clipboard and then paste it into a variety of different file formats. So this would be all for our tutorial on how to post-process your results from a parametric sweep.